gosh, I loved it so much. And that is a big thing for me to say. I have an unpopular opinion with this one, and I'm so sorry in advance. I feel so cute. I'm wearing this like adorable 70s denim suit, and I feel like a badass bitch, okay? Hi guys, my name is Sabine, and welcome to another video. Today, I want to talk about the 4 books that I read during the month of August. But first, a word from today's sponsor. Which is Skillshare. I am so excited that I am working with them yet again, and it is all because of your support. If you didn't know already, Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. They offer thousands of inspiring classes on topics including illustration, design, photography, video, anything that you can think of, it is basically on Skillshare. I have personally loved taking classes, for instance, to improve my Spanish and also for editing in Premiere Pro or to help me draw on apps such as Procreate. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a free 1-month trial of Skillshare Premium so that you can explore your creativity and follow the classes like I did. So thank you so much to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. Now let's go on and get right into the wrap up. So August was a pretty decent reading month for me. I lately haven't really been in the reading mood, but that's just because a lot of life changes are coming at me at once. I'm moving houses again. I have my own little dorm in Utrecht, which is like a city right in the middle in the Netherlands. And I will be starting my second bachelor's degree, psychology, within exactly a week the moment that I'm filming this, and it's like making me nervous and I am kind of scared for the change, but I'm also excited. It's just that I don't know a lot of people there, and it's usually not really the place that makes you feel like you're at home but the people. So that's what's making me a little bit nervous and what has been taking over my mind lately, hence why I haven't been able to focus a lot on reading. But I don't know if September will be any better because I will of course have to adjust to everything, but I'm gonna do my best. We shall see how September will go. Right now, let's talk about the first book that I finished in August. And that was actually surprisingly a very good one. And that is One of Us is Next by Karen M. McManus. This is the sequel to One of Us is Lying, which I absolutely adored. Read it in April. It is a YA murder mystery. They're kind of like companion novels, so you don't have to read the first book, but I would highly recommend you because a lot of the characters in book one are like secondary characters in this one, and in the sequel you kind of hear more about what happened after the events of book one, so it's not a necessity, but I would highly recommend it. In book one we follow 5 teens who get the tension, but once that has happened only 4 of them leave the classroom alive, and they're all suspects for the murder on Simon Callagher, who owned this like gossip app, and all of the 4 students who are now suspects had their own secrets. And in this one you have the same school, you have a couple of like side characters or new characters that you meet. There is another year, another drama, a whole new set of rules. There is a mysterious app made by someone who is creating these like very strange truth or dares, challenges, things. I did not figure out who the person was behind all of these shenanigans, so I always love it when that kind of like plot twist thingy happens. What I also adore about Karen M. McManus's YA thrillers until so far is that it's not just about like the murder and the mystery. You also get to know the characters as well. You get to hear about their backstories and their reasoning behind certain choices that they make. So it really feels like she cares a lot about her characters as well and makes sure that they have a nice backstory. So I'm super excited to be reading more from Karen M. McManus. This one definitely has like a cliffhanger ending, so there must be a book 3 coming in this trilogy, I think. But I'm also just really excited to check out her other works. I believe she has a couple of standalones. Then, oh my god, I did it. I did it. I don't know how, but I did it. I finished The Burning God by R.F. Kuang. This is the 3rd and final book in the Poppy War trilogy, and I have an unpopular opinion with this one, and I'm so sorry in advance. And that is that the series for me personally goes downhill with each book that I read. So this is book 3, and book 1 is my absolute fave. In the Poppy War, we follow our main character, Rin. She is kind of like a peasant girl. She faces a lot of discrimination in the country of Nikara, more specifically racism, because she also has dark skin. But then she gets into one of the most pristine schools of the country, and she comes in touch with like elemental magic, and there is a war happening. So it's a lot of shamanism, a lot of elemental magic, war strategics, and the first half of this book is like private school, learning the elements. And then the second half goes a lot more into war strategics, warfare. I found out after continuing on with this series with book 2 and 3 that warfare is not my favorite thing to read about. It definitely interests me less than the elemental magic that is in these stories, but I do know and I do recognize that R.F. Kuan has done amazing research, because there are a lot of parallels with modern Chinese history with these books and like a real time war that happened in the 1950s. And whilst I was reading the third and final book, which is a brick, hence why I'm so proud of myself, I recognized while reading that a lot of amazing things were happening and big plot twists and a lot of intense decisions with catastrophic consequences like the first two books. But for some reason, they just didn't hit me as hard as they did with book 1. And I don't know what is not here in this book that could have made me completely obsessed with it. I just have no clue. Maybe I feel less of a connection to the characters than in book 1, but I don't know. I wish I was a better reviewer so that I can pinpoint what exactly it is that I'm missing, but the audiobooks are fantastic and definitely like helped me get through the books. The narrator of them does such a good job. Then I read a nonfiction book about racism in the Netherlands called Hallo Witte Mensen by Anusha Nazume. Hallo Witte Mensen translates to Hello White People. And I have read a couple of other nonfiction books about racism, but those are mostly focused on racism in the US and the UK. And although there are a lot of similarities in racism between those countries and the Netherlands, I do feel like there are certain situations that needed more nuance and like the perspective from a Dutch person, and that is exactly what I got from this book. I wrote down so many amazing quotes that I've learned a lot from, and I really want to lend out this book to more of like my Dutch family and friends, because I still feel like a lot of people, including myself, still need to learn a lot about racism and mostly like how implicit certain like comments are or jokes. And I think that if we become more aware of that, we can change our like assumptions or what we say or certain terms that we use. So I'm really happy that I picked up this book and that some of my friends and family will be able to learn from it as well. And then the last book that I literally just finished today is something completely different, and that is Tweet Cute by Emma Lord. And the title says it all. It is cute, adorable. Oh my gosh, I loved it so much. And that is a big thing for me to say, because I'm usually not the biggest fan of romance, and especially YA romance, but this is my new fave, YA romance, definitely. So in this book, we follow two different main characters. So you have a like double point of view, namely those of Jack and Pepper. Pepper is the head of the swim team. Her parents own this like huge company called Big League Burger, and it's like a burger chain restaurant spread all over the US. And she is really struggling to combine school life with also keeping up to date with the Burger League Twitter account. And then we have Jack, whose family owns a smaller company in New York as well. He's also super busy with being part of the diving team, but also helping his parents out at the deli. And then Pepper's family company steals a grilled cheese recipe from Jack's family's company. And a huge Twitter war between the two explodes. Happens. But besides all of the memes and the retweets and the Twitter battle that's happening between them, they are also talking on this anonymous chat app, and they are slowly falling for each other on the app, but also maybe in real life. So as the book continues on, their relationship deepens, but also the Twitter war, and it's just a lot of snarly comments, a lot of jokes. But what I adored so much is like the family aspect of these books. It definitely has a lot of depth in it as well, like trying to tell your parents what you really want to do in life, and maybe it's different from their expectations, but also dealing with the pressure of high school and going to college and having to do everything for that and be like the most perfect student that you can be, whilst also including a cute, adorable romance and just lovely grown-up YA characters, which I was so pleasantly surprised by. I usually feel like when you read a YA romance, you can definitely tell that the characters are like 16 or 15. They are just written like so young and irresponsible, but I feel like that doesn't do justice to how young people can also be, which is the complete opposite of that. And I felt like Jack and Pepper were so responsible and they communicated so well, because I hate the trope of where everything goes wrong due to not communicating with people. And I'm happy to say that this book does not have that trope. And also just all of the baking and the cooking in this book is what I absolutely adore. Apparently I really like books that include that as a theme as well. I loved Emma Lord's writing style, so I cannot wait to check out her other books in the near future as well, and would highly recommend you to pick up this one if you haven't yet. So those were the four books that I read during the month of August. Let me know in the comments down below if you've read any of these books too and what your thoughts are, or also the other books that you read during the month of August. I'm really excited to chat about the books in the comments down below. Again, don't forget to check out my Skillshare link in the description box. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking somewhere here on the screen or in the button down below, and hopefully I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!